Imagine a town with a bustling downtown business district. There are several clothing stores, a few coffee shops, a bunch of restaurants, and all sorts of specialty stores. You have lots of options of places to spend your hard-earned money. Is this a good thing? Is it bad? Well, that's a matter of personal preference, but there has to be some benefit to all these choices competing for your money. In a market economy, those businesses competing for your money are incentivized to try and best meet your needs and wants. In previous lessons, we've talked about how market forces like price, demand, and supply interact in the market. Today, we're going to look at how market structure and the number of firms impact competition, another important market force. By the end of today's lesson, you should be able to answer the following questions. What are the four types of competition? How does competition impact consumer welfare and market power? How can individuals help promote competition in a market economy? And you should start thinking about our big picture question. Why is competition important in a market economy? In your PDF, you'll find a graphic organizer to help take notes about the different types of competition. We're going to examine these from most competitive to the least competitive. We're going to discuss them in terms of the numbers of firms, product differentiation, barriers to entry, and a firm's ability to set prices for its products. The term barriers to entry refers to obstacles or challenges that make it difficult for new businesses to enter a particular market or industry. In pure competition, many small firms compete with each other to sell very similar or identical products. In this structure, there are few barriers to entry, but producers have little control over the prices of their goods or services. Take a lemonade stand, for example. It is relatively easy to open one and sell lemonade. There can be many stands operating in a market, each selling a pretty similar product. And price is determined by what consumers are willing to pay and what producers are willing to sell the lemonade for. In monopolistic competition, many firms sell similar but slightly differentiated products. There are generally low barriers to entry, but because products are slightly different, producers have a degree of control on setting prices. A great example of this is the market for clothing. It's relatively easy to get into the field because firms just need to be able to produce an article of clothing, like a t-shirt. A plain store brand t-shirt has the same function and is made from similar materials as a designer brand t-shirt. But thanks to advertising and the perceived value of different brands, the designer t-shirt can be sold for a lot more money than the store brand. In oligopoly, there are a few firms that dominate the production and distribution of a good or service. In this structure, there are high barriers to entry. Firms sell similar goods and services, and producers have a tight control over the price of that good or service. However, any decision or action by one of the firms can have a huge impact on other firms. Take airlines as an example. It takes a lot of resources to start an airline, so there are only a few in the country. And each airline can basically set the price of a ticket however they want to. But if one airline suddenly drops fares for an entire summer, other airlines may be forced to do the same in order to compete. In a monopoly, there is one firm with control over production and distribution of a good or service in a market. there are high barriers to entry for firms and monopolies. However, these firms in this type of competitive structure have tight control over the ability to set prices. A great example of a monopoly is the electric company. In most places, one company provides all of the electricity to the market. It is difficult for new firms to enter the market because it is expensive and time-consuming to build the necessary infrastructure. This allows the company to set prices and fees for users. Let's take a second to practice. OPEC is a group of 13 nations that produce around 30% of the world's oil. These nations work together to make decisions about production levels and help set the price of oil in the market. However, these nations can act independently, often impacting what other member nations do. What type of competition is this? What is your rationale for this decision? But aside from price, what impact does competition have on consumers? Well, a lot, actually. When we examine the different types of competition in a market, we could look at a couple of factors: consumer welfare and market power. Consumer welfare is the level of well-being or satisfaction that consumers get from a good or service. The other part of profitability for businesses is increasing revenue by selling to more customers at the best possible price. The key to this is providing a good or service that people want. More competition in a market forces businesses to make sure they are producing goods and services that maximize consumer welfare in order to generate sales, revenue, and hopefully profit. And market power is the ability of a company to influence the prices and availability of goods or services in a particular market. In markets with less competition, companies have much more market power. If there's only one place that sells a good or service, you as a consumer are forced to either pay what the company wants for the product or just not buy it. But as competition increases, that market power shifts from the business toward the consumer. Let's use Mia's lemonade stand as an example. If she's the only stand in town, she might be able to sell lemonade for $3 a glass. But if someone else opens up a competing stand and decides to sell for $2 a glass, consumers now have a choice. Mia can lower her price to compete with the new stand or face going out of business. Let's take a second to think about this practically. Imagine your town has one grocery store. It has a terrible selection, the service is not great, and everything is so expensive. People in your town are upset at the situation and wonder how it got so bad. How could you use concepts about types of competition, consumer welfare, and market power to explain the situation? I'm sure you're fascinated by all of this information, but asking yourself, how does this impact my daily life? Well, thinking about types of competition can help you consider how you use your power as a consumer and a citizen to influence the market. As a consumer, the choices you make in how to spend your money and who to buy goods and services from can impact competition in your area. Sometimes you may shop at a giant superstore in your area because it's easier or a little less expensive. Other times you may choose to shop at a small local business for some of the harder to find items or something from a local producer. While there are trade-offs to those choices, making decisions that encourage competition helps ensure that there are a variety of options to meet the needs of consumers in your area. As a citizen, you can push elected officials to adopt policies that encourage economic competition. And in cases where it's difficult to foster competition, you might want to encourage those officials to ensure that firms don't take advantage of consumers. But we'll dive deeper into that area when we discuss the role of government in a market. Time for your last guiding question. Your friend is trying to tell you that thinking about competition in markets isn't that big a deal. What can you tell them to change their mind? Okay, let's take a few minutes to go back over what we covered. There are four types of market structures with varying levels of competition: pure competition, monopolistic competition, oligopoly, and monopoly. And these different types of competition impact the consumer welfare and market power found in a market. Most importantly, thinking about issues around competition in the marketplace can help us be better consumers and citizens. In tomorrow's lesson, we're going to examine how these market forces impact Mia and her lemonade stand. But until then, keep investing in yourself, one lesson at a time. I'll see you next time. Hey.